Hi guys, Kevin here. Welcome back to some more car builds leading all the way up to Christmas. And it is the 20th car build today. Unfortunately, we did miss one day earlier in the week, but this is the 20th of December. So this is the 20th car build. And number 19 was this BMW M3. It looks absolutely clean as hell. Look how clean that looks. That looks probably my best looking car, to be fair. It looks insane, and it's probably one of the best drifters as well. So if you haven't checked out that video, I recommend you do go check that out. It's a very, very, very good car. So yeah, on to the next thing I want to say. In the comments below, leave a comment with what car you want to see next episode, and I will basically do the one with the most thumbs up. So if you see one with something that you like, with a car you like, give it a thumbs up, and the one with the most thumbs up will get chosen. Sorry, but I don't know what, I can't speak. This isn't me like not thinking this time, this is me, my throat not letting me speak. But yeah, let's jump on to the next one. The comment was by Johnny Quango, and he says the Chevelle SS naturally aspirated max power. Okay, so this is gonna be insane. Okay, so here is the Chevelle SS 1970s. It has 450 horsepower as stock, so with max power this car is gonna be insane. I'm not gonna lie, but it's fun, it's all fun. Let's see if there's any, oh, kind of like that. Let's see if there's any nice paints in here. They're all kind of like hot rod kind of paints, so they will look pretty good on this car, I'm not gonna lie. So let's go for something. Let's go for that. That looks pretty nice. It's got a nice clean feel to it. It looks different as well. It's got a two-tone paint, which is probably wouldn't come across online too much either. So that's that. Yeah, I'm trying to record this on the Elgato software today. Basically, they've put in the fact that you can use a webcam. So yeah, I don't know how this is going to turn out. I'm sorry if it is a little bit off sync, but I'm just testing out this one time, and if I watch it back through once I've uploaded it and it seems okay, I will probably use it from now on. But hey, yeah, on to the actual video. So let's go into the upgrades here, custom upgrades, and he said naturally aspirated engine. Okay, so it's already rear wheel drive as well, so there's nothing we can change in here. We could have put a supercharger in, but stock aspiration there. Bumpers and that, I don't think there's going to be too much there. Let's not do that. And let's really not do that. I just don't like the look of that at all. That could be quite cool. That could be quite cool. Adds a kind of, I don't know, let's just stick with the stock one for now. You can put that on in your own car if you do want to. Seeing as this is going to have a little bit of power, I'm going to go with street tyres here. And whips, let's go 245s on the front, and on the rear, let's go, let's go 255s. I was thinking about going for the 295s there. But we could change that if we do need to in the future. Okay, so on to wheels. Let's go into the specialized category here. They're pretty nice wheels to stock, to be fair. So, I don't know. What could we put on this? Let's go for these bad boys. Let's go for those. We're going to make a little bit bigger. Obviously, on kind of muscle cars, they don't have big rim sizes, but yeah, let's just do it. 17 inch on there. Try and make it a little bit tuner style. But yeah, it's all to your personal taste. You can make this however you do want to. So onto the drivetrain, everything here will be quite literally zero. No, it'll be everything race. So everything in here will be race. Don't do the Storm Island transmission or it'll be turd. So let's do race driveline and the race differential. So yeah, this car looks absolutely mean as it looks now. And with the added power in this, it's going to be absolutely scary. Pretty much, it's just going to be scary. So let's put the race ride height on there. It looks pretty sick on the rear, a little bit of wheel tuck there. If you go for the rim size higher, it would probably be a little bit more tucked. But yeah, that looks pretty sick. Should we roll cage it? Yeah, why not? It looks pretty sick. It looks pretty sick, so let's do that. Race weight reduction, 1,400 kilos in this car. Yeah, I'm debating about those street tyres now, but let's leave them on for now. We can change that if we do need to. So let's do max power, basically. Got asked to do max power, so let's go in and upgrade all of this. Okay, so 479 horsepower. I reckon this could probably get to about 600, maybe a little bit further. So that's already on. Race exhaust, 500. Camshaft should push it. Camshafts are a very good upgrade. So 590 horsepower, should I say. So it's going to just go over 600, hopefully. And that should be, that'll probably be about the right power, to be fair. Seeing as it weighs a lot and we're running street tyres, it'll probably be just about fine. 632 horsepower there. And 638 horsepower. Okay, so that's that. Put the race flywheel on to save an extra tiny 4 kilograms of weight. And that is that. So let's jump out now into free roam. And let's start free roaming this bad boy. Okay, so that actually looks quite sick from the side. Okay. Sorry if I sound a little bit weird, but I think I've got like a cold coming on. It's like the back of my nose is all blocked up. Like the back of your mouth and slash nose, if you know what I mean. Like, it's all blocked up, but we'll deal with it. It's fine. So yeah, this is a muscle car, so it's gonna drift pretty well, to be fair, as stock. So we could maybe get the tires in the rear sliding a little bit more. And it's typical, like, I finish work and then I start getting ill. Like, come on, can't I get ill when I'm at work? Please. So yeah, this car sounds absolutely meaty. Oh, splice that gap. It's not ever so sharp in the transitions, but it is a very heavy muscle car. I don't really expect any different. So it's still raining here. Is it ever going to stop raining, please? So yeah, it holds mad angle, to be fair. It feels pretty nice to stock. If I do make some changes, it's not going to be mad changes, to be fair, because this actually does feel quite nice. On that tight corner, it does seem to oversteer a bit too much, so we could try and stabilize the car a little bit more. Probably aim to do that. Front tires feel fine in the wheel. We could lower the tire pressure in the rear just a tiny bit. Try and get that extra little bit of grip. So I'm going to shorten the gears just the smallest amount. It should be fine though. Let's camber it a tiny smidge. And the front seems fine though. I'm going to leave that. So 5.5 caster. Anti-roll bars seem fine. Springs. It's quite soft. So I'm going to make it a lot stiffer. I like my car stiffer, so that is what I am going to do. You could keep it where it is if you do prefer to use the body weight for like faint entries, or you use your body weight a little bit more. But for what I do, I use handbrake more. So I'm going to leave that where it is. Differential could go 100%, 100%. And that should be a pretty good base tune onto this car. What I am going to do is going to teleport over to the industrial area. Just so we get no traffic, we can just test this car for its angle, its stability, etc. But it felt pretty nice through that section already, so I don't think there's going to be much tuning on this car. Seeing as on Horizon, you don't actually have to really tune cars, to be honest. Just to add that extra little bit of stability. And that's about it. So, still raining. Not shocked. It's all that seems to happen in my videos. Just rain all the time. So let's head down into our start point. yeah, this engine sounds absolutely incredible. Didn't expect anything less, to be honest. It is obviously a Chevrolet, so it's gonna have a nice engine in here. Okay, so that is very stable. Not the fastest transition, but you kind of expect that with a car of this size and weight. But then it holds angle like that. That's crazy. I was expecting to spin out then, but it just came and it just held its own angle. So that was good. It's got the power to spin up the wheels in gear 3 perfectly. And the gear 3 is the perfect length for anything, really. This section is absolutely spot on. So that felt very good. Obviously, it is still raining at the moment, so it's going to be a little bit slidier than normal. And I didn't mean to do that. But let's jump into this. Whoa, look at that. Look at that, like, sun on the left. That looks wicked. That looks sick. So, yeah. Let's try and keep drifting this. But, yeah, it feels very nice. It's got just the right about amount of power, to be honest. Because, obviously, it is a very heavy car. I think this weight complements that quite well. And it can hold angle like that. All that. And then it's got the stability as well, so you could chuck this car in with mad angle and it'll probably come out your friend. So yeah, pretty nice car, to be honest. I don't think there's gonna be many more changes, to be honest. It feels pretty spot on already. So yeah, I'm gonna give it one more run, seeing that it has dried up in this world. Look how stable that is. That's incredible. Oh my god, I was looking at the tire marks on the floor and I wasn't concentrating on where I was actually going. Yeah. So yeah, that feels a very nice car. That bass tune, you don't really have to tune this car, to be honest. It felt very good as stock. But I've done a little bass tune that does improve the stability of this car. So that's good. What I'm going to do now is upload this tune onto the storefront for you guys to download. If you can't be bothered to put the tune and the upgrades on yourself, you can just go onto the storefront, click load setup, and just search for Gaylord tag, which is Kevin Toll. So let's go. I really need to sort this code out. I can't get rid of this code. It's really annoying. But yeah, let's just save this as drift, and let's do that. So yeah, very nice car. Hope you guys do check out this car. A little bit different. It's a muscle car. I've been doing a lot of JDM cars. So it's a good change. And it's one of the best cars. So yeah, I'm putting out loads of good cars, which is good. That's what I kind of wanted to do, like, with this series. There's 25 more drift cars in my garage that I can use. So it's good for me and it's good for you guys as well. So hope you guys enjoyed this. And if you did, give it a thumbs up. And I'll see you guys next time.